We're on?
We're on?
Yeah.
You should start doing your job.
I'm sorry.
Good evening, folks. I'm Ben Craig with the Channel 61 News Team, your hurricane specialist. Today we go look back at the hurricane that was, Hurricane Charley. Charley brought three nations havoc and destruction. Throughout this segment, two experts, Craig Fisher and Eric Reed, will give you an in-depth analysis of one of the most devastating natural disasters in the history of the world.
Charley was no walk on the beach.
Lasting from August 9 to the 14th in 2004, the storm hit Jamaica as it moved on its destructive path, disrupting the Cayman Islands, North and South Carolina.
Great! Come on!
Why?
Because you have to!
Fine! Oh, hello there! The total human casualties is not exact. It is estimated at 35 deaths. 15 direct deaths and 20 indirect due to this disaster.
Oh, God. Oh, welcome back. Thanks, Craig. Now we go to Eric Reed.
Yeah. Oh. Hey there. Yes, as you may have known, Charley initially expected to hit in further Tampa. It caught many Floridians off guard from a sudden change to the northeast. This little tight came out as a tropical wave that moved off the coast of Africa on August 4th. Convection currents caused it to move in curved bands westward. Oh, welcome back. High pressure from the north caused it to move to the west-northwest. Then later on, sped to the north-northeast in response to an unseasonal mid-tropospheric trough.
Hello, and welcome to our feature presentation. Hurricane Charley was a difficult storm to forecast due to its fast motion.
Early 96 and 120-hour forecasts for the storm were poorly done. However, future forecasts within 48 hours were accurate and showed the landfall of the hurricane south of Tampa.
Finally, the intensity forecast was significantly inaccurate due to a ship that had reported that the storm had degenerated into a wave, which significantly affected the intensity of the forecast.
Later, this was known not as the case, whereas Charlie merely had a very small vortex. Shortly after, it was classified as a Category 3 hurricane, but no one ever stated that Charlie could become a Category 4 hurricane.
Recommended watches and warnings were issued accordingly. Cuba received more than 36 hours of lead time for the one recommended warning. The FL landfall zone received about 30, the east coast of FL about 18, and the Carolinas about 24.
Such measures that can be taken into precaution are that community members with chronic conditions such as diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and asthma should be warned of storms well in advance.
Of course, this was due to their special needs to access medical equipment. Portable generators can also be used, seeing as how they are becoming more available to communities, but they need to be taught how to use these generators.
These effects could be minimized by keeping cars in garages, boarding windows, tying down loose objects, and whatever else may come to mind.
Thank you, Eric. Well, that concludes our segment for today, as we learned a lot of information about Hurricane Charlie. On behalf of the Channel 61 News team, I'm Ben Frege. You stay classy, North America.
Well, where's the Faraday hat?
Faraday, that was awesome, gang.
That was awesome. Awesome. Awesome.
You know we're still on.
Oh, whoa.
My temple.